morning everyone. Welcome to your English class, dear students. Today we will do the explanation of lesson number 2, event story. And this is my first video, that's why I have written part 1. Today's part of the day is, if you are positive, you will see opportunities instead of obstacles. Dear students, this lesson is written by Catherine Applegate. Catherine Applegate is an American writer whose works include fantasies and adventures, novels. Her children's novel, The One and the Only Iran, has been recognized for the way in which the writer makes us think about how we treat animals and the feelings that animals have. Dear students, this lesson, Iran's story, is a part of the novel, the children's novel, The One and the Only Iran. So, in this lesson, we are going to read about Iran's life, who was a gorilla, and we are also going to get the information about how the gorilla was treated when he was just a baby at that time. Iran is a gorilla who lives in a cage at a mall. He has spent 27 years either living in a human home or at the mall. The story told by Iran is about how he was nearly forgotten. He has nearly forgotten his life in the wild. The book was inspired by the true story of Iran, who lived in a similar situation for 27 years. Dear students, as I have read the introduction of this story, it tells us that this is a true story. This story is based on true story of Iran, who lived in similar situations for 27 years. He spent his life in cage in the mall or at human homes. Dear students, as you go through this book, through this lesson number 2, you will find out that there are different topics which are given on the pages, and you will see that these different topics reflect the different aspects of Iran's life. Now we will read these different aspects one by one and find out about Iran's story deeply. Now the first topic is the grunt. Grunt means a short, low sound. I am also writing it on the board. Grunt means short, low sound. I was born in a place humans call Central Africa, in a dense rainforest, so beautiful. No crayons could ever do it justice. Gorillas do not name their newborns right away, the way humans do. We get to know our babies first. We wait to see hints of what might yet be. When they saw how much she loved to chase me around the forest, my parents decided on my twin sister's name, Tag. Oh, how I love to play tag with my sister. She was nimble, but when I got too close, she would leap onto my unsuspecting father. Then I would join her, and we would bounce on his belly until he gave us a grunt, a sound that meant enough. That game never got old, although my father might have disagreed. Now, in this topic, the grunt, it tells us, basically it is telling us about the low sound, low short sound which was produced by his father when Iran and her and his sister Tag used to bounce on his belly. He used to produce that grunting sound to tell the babies that now that's enough. In the beginning of this para, it's been told that Iran was born in the Central Africa, which is called the as mud. It did not take long for my parents to find my name. All day long, every day, I made pictures. I drew on rocks and bark and my poor mother's back. I used the sap from leaves. I used the juice from fruit. But mostly, I used mud. And that is what they called me, mud. To a human, mud might not sound like much, but to me it was everything. Now, the next topic, mud, tells us that the early name given to Ivan by his parents was mud, because he used to love playing with mud. He used to make pictures, he used to make drawings on different things like rocks, bark, and even his mother's back. He used to make pictures even on his mother's back using leaves, sap from leaves and juices from fruits, and mostly he used mud. He loved to play with mud, that's why his parents named him Mud. And Ivan tells us that to a human being, this particular name which was given to him in the early period of his life, Mud, did not mean much, but for the gorilla, for Ivan, that name Mud meant everything for him. Now, our next topic is protector, which is given on page number 3. My family, which human calls a troop, was just like any other gorilla family. There were 10 of us, my father, the silver back, my mother and the 3 other adult females, a young male called a black back, and 2 other young gorillas. Ted and I were the babies of the group. We fought from time to time, but my father knew how to control us with a simple scowl. And for the most part, we were happy to do what we were meant to do, to feed and search for food and nap